Hello. Today we will talk about bioprocesses for the production of natural vanillin. As we have seen before, vanillin is the flavor molecule with by far the largest production volume. Nearly 100 tons are produced by fermentation each year, and we will have today a closer look at the different ways to obtain vanillin biotechnologically. But at first, we will get to know something about the properties of vanillin. Vanillin has a typical vanilla-like, sweet, creamy, chocolate-like smell. The taste is described as vanilla-like, vanillin, sweet, creamy, and phenolic. Therefore, the main applications in food are in the ice cream, chocolates, bakery, and dairy products, sweets, as well as beverages. But now we will come back to the production processes. There are mainly two chemical production processes. The largest process starts with guaiacol, a fossil oil-based chemical, while the second one uses lignin, a waste product of paper pulping. In the past, also eugenol was used as a starting material. All these processes will not result in a natural flavor. As the demand for natural vanillin is high, and the vanilla pods are not a sufficient source, despite of an exorbitant price, there are still a lot of efforts for biotechnological process to obtain natural vanillin. When we look at the molecule, we see that it is a relatively simple small molecule. It is a substituted phenolic aldehyde. In general, there are two possibilities to obtain vanillin. The first one is the de novo synthesis from glucose, as it is also done in the vanilla plant. The second is a biotransformation of a natural occurring molecule with a similar structure. Both ways have been gone, and we will have now a closer look at the different processes. Let's start with a de novo synthesis from glucose. Already in 1998, Lee and Frost from the Michigan State University described a two-step process for the production of vanillin. They used a recombinant E. coli strain and obtained in a fat batch fermentation 5 grams per liter of vanillic acid after 48 hours. Vanillic acid has then been reduced by an aryl aldehyde dihydrogenase isolated from Neurospora crassa with a 92% conversion rate within 7 hours to vanillin. They received a patent for this process in 2002. The authors themselves realized that this process was not sufficient for a commercial production and that further optimization, especially the integration of aryl aldehyde dehydrogenase into a microbial host, would be necessary, as this enzyme is NADPH dependent. A second process based on glucose was published in 2009 by Hansen et al., who used either Saccharomyces cerevisia and the fission yeast Schizosaccharomyces pombe as a host for the recombinant process. They introduced the genes encoding 3-dehydroshikimate dihydrogenase from the dung mold Podospora pauci zeta to catalyze the formation of protocatechuic acid from 3-dehydroshikimate. From the protocatechuic acid, the pathway then proceeds either via vanillic acid formed by O-methylation by the O-methyl transferase from Homo sapiens, and then by reduction by the aromatic carboxylic acid reductase from Nocardia iovensis to obtain vanillin. Alternatively, the reaction scheme of the two last steps can be exchanged. For good expression of the genes, it was necessary to adopt the codon usage of the foreign genes to that of the yeasts. To avoid the toxicity of vanillin, it was glycosylated by an Arabidopsis thaliana UDP glycosyl transferase, converting the formed vanillin into vanillin beta-D glucoside. This process was developed by the Swiss company Evolva together with IFF. They announced in 2014 that pervanillin was brought to market, but up to now, no significant amounts were seen on the market. The ways to vanillin by biotransformations are manifold. There are numerous natural aromatic molecules which can act as a precursor for the formation of vanillin, and for all of these processes, methods have been described. In the 1990s, Dolfini et al. From the Mallinckrodt company filed a patent for the hydrolysis of curcumin to obtain vanillin. Curcumin is the main compound of turmeric oleoresin from the herb curcuma longa, and it is used as a yellowish-orange dye in foodstuffs. As you can see, when looking at the chemical structure, it is possible to obtain two molecules of vanillin from one molecule of curcumin. They hydrolyzed curcumin at 316 degrees Celsius and at a pressure of 21.8 bar. This can only be considered as a US natural process, but it would not be accepted under the EU regulation. But there are also some biotechnological approaches to obtain vanillin from curcumin. In 2011, Bharti and Gupta described the conversion of curcumin with a strain of Rhodococcus rhodochrus. They obtained 3.56 milligrams vanillin from 29.02 milligrams of natural curcumin. This is by far too low for the commercial process. The group of Berger from Hannover published in 2015 a process with three isolated enzymes. First, the phenolic hydroxyl groups were protected via acetylation. In a second step, the molecule was hydrolyzed by a lactase. And in a third step, the acetyl group was removed with a ferulyl esterase. This process is also not commercially feasible due to the low concentration and yields. Isoeugenol was one of the first precursors applied for the production of natural vanillin. In 1991, when I was at Hamann and Reimer, we found that species of the genera Serratia, Enterobacter, and Klebsiella were able to convert isoeugenol to vanillin. With Serratium assistance, we obtained, after 9 days, a concentration of 3.8 grams of vanillin. This process was commercially not attractive, as most of the producing organisms belong to the security level 2. A second drawback was that natural isoeugenol is, in contrast to eugenol, only found as a minor component in a number of special essential oils like ylang-ylang and nutmeg. Another natural precursor is eugenol. It is the main constituent of the essential oil of a clove tree, Syzygium aromaticum. It is available in high volumes and at a relatively low price. A number of Pseudomonas species are able to metabolize eugenol, despite the fact that it is a relatively high antimicrobial active compound. In the 1990s, we at Hamann and Reimer isolated Pseudomonas species 199, which was able to degrade eugenol. The metabolites detected analytically indicate the following pathway. Eugenol is oxidized in the first step to coniferyl alcohol and then via coniferyl aldehyde to ferulic acid, which is deacetylated to vanillic acid. Together with a group of Professor Steinbüchel from the University of Münster, we analyzed the genetics. As it can be seen in the chart, vanillin is an intermediate in the degradation pathway, but the vanillin dihydrogenase is so active that it was not possible to detect even trace amounts of vanillin in the wild-type strain culture. By construction and deletion mutant of the VDH gene, it was possible to produce vanillin. In the flask scale, the concentration was very low due to the limited concentration of eugenol, which can be added. In a carefully controlled fat patch process, it was possible to increase the concentration significantly. But the problem remains that coniferyl aldehyde dihydrogenase has also a VDH activity. The commercial successful process is based on the microbial biotransformation of ferulic acid. Ferulic acid is an abundant phenolic phytochemical mainly found in plant cell walls. Ferrite is esterified with polysaccharides, flavonoids, hydroxycarboxylic acids, and long-chain alcohols. Commercially available, it is either from the bran of rice, wheat, or from corn. Several groups have studied a number of different organisms where vanillin is an intermediate in the degradation of ferulic acid. At Hammann and Reimer, we developed in the mid-1990s a process with a strain of Amicordatopsis species HR167. This strain was able to produce a high concentration of vanillin from ferulic acid in a fed batch fermentation process. After optimization, about 11.5 grams of vanillin with a molar yield of 77.8% was obtained within 1.5 days. A few months later, a patent from Juheim and Lerch from Givaudan patented a very similar process using Streptomyces cetonae ATCC39160. Later on, it became clear by genetic analysis that both strains belong to the same species, which is now classified as Amicordatopsis cetonae. This process is nowadays the only commercial process. The H&R patent was sold in 2016 to Rhodia, which was later bought by Solvay. Solvay is now the world's largest producer of natural vanillin from ferulic acid. The advantage of this process is that it is a natural, non-genetically engineered strain, which is, at least in Europe, a significant advantage for products which are used in the food area. In the meantime, the production strain has been optimized by genetic engineering by the group of Steinbüchel on behalf of Symrise. By deletion of the VDH gene and the constitutive expression of a vanillin anabolism genes ECH and FCS, a final vanillin concentration of 19.3 grams per liter with a molar yield of 94.9% was obtained. We achieved an even higher final vanillin concentration of 22.3 grams per liter at the expense of a lower molar yield by using an improved feeding strategy. This is the highest vanillin concentration by biotransformation disclosed so far. Zeng et al. Published in 2005 a method using two fungal strains. In a first step, a strain of Aspergillus niger produced vanillic acid, which was then, in a second step, reduced to vanillin by a strain of Pycnoporus cinnabarinus. Only 2.2 grams of vanillic acid was obtained in the first step. In the second step, 2.8 grams of vanillin were formed.